Welcome back, folks, to more Condom. I have to say right now that I was doing a little researching on YouTube for other people that have done Arcanum. Wow. The amount of subscribers some of these fucking dick leakers have is just blows my mind. I guess there's a lot of little fucking 10-year-olds or some shit that watch YouTube and like to listen to nasally little nerd fucks. I personally just watch some of these goddamn people LPing games and I just shake my head because it's a fucking shame. Just complete fucking nitwit dorks. You want to hear a real fucking man, Diesel goddamn LP? You come to fucking Ronstock's house, baby. That's how the game hoarder does it. Fuck all these other nerds. Anyways, in Roseboro here, the stone vault looks ancient. An inscription on its face reads, "Ye must know the word that opens all doors." Truth! Mug Mug happens to know that very word. You find the Sword of Manox in the Journal of St. Manox. And some dirty tampons and a bowl of fucking jizz and put out campfire. Lug Lug not reading all that! Okay, so for now, let's head back to Caledon! One thing we need to do, we need to talk to Lady Misk here.
Hello, Mr. Misk. Have you a moment? I must be off. Talk with you about the book in the display case.
Oh, that's called the Book of Durin's Truth, an ancient dwarven tome. It was one of Victor's most prized possessions.
I'm in need of that book. Is there anywhere I might procure it?
Why on earth would you need to have that very book?
You see, I'm searching for the Iron Clan.
An interesting quest, my friend. Perhaps I might be interested in selling it after all. Are you interested in buying it?
Of course. What price were you thinking?
Why, how about 2,000? More than a fair price.
Done.
Thank you. Here's the key. Take the book at your leisure.
I must be going. My book! Lug Lug collects books now like game order. I have 3. How many do you have?
That, of course, puts on our map the location of the Iron Clan in the Stonewall Range. Now let's return to the Punani Church. Oh, I mean the Punari Church.
Did I say Punani? My bad. My bad, kiddies.
I actually do have a couple younger generation guys that, kids, I guess, that watch the videos. Young adults, if you will. Young adults. And I always find it quite amusing. But, you know what? I give them daps, props, if you will, for being into the older generation games. It's kind of like the cool kids that can't stand listening to the shitty 2000-plus music. And so they're into the 80s and 90s, which is actually when music was still good. But, you know, anyone can appreciate these classic games for what they are. They obviously just fucking decimate and desecrate all this new garbage that they're putting out on shelves now. Not only is the material packaging light years shittier now than it used to be, but also these fucking little twat 6 to 8 hour games that you're paying $60 for. Come on, man. Fuck that. That's complete garbage. Once in a while, yeah, you'll get some epic shit like Skyrim or Fallout or fucking, you know, some great game like that, but ask them what inspired them back in the day. They're going to tell you right away games like this, you know, Ultima, you know, the early Fallout series. It all leads back to the roots, and that's what we're here to do on this channel, is to relive the roots and the classics from a guy that grew up with this shit. Not some little faggoty 22-year-old that this is his first time playing Arcanum. His first time playing King's Quest 1 EGA. You know, fuck you. If you didn't own a 286 or a 386 or fucking a 486, if you didn't own any one of those generations, you can suck my dick. Oh, it's you! You finally come, the blimp crash survivor. You have any idea what this means? It's you. You're the living one. It's a miracle. Let's not blow this out of proportion. Out of proportion? This is an astronomical event. The return of Nazardin. The final battle. The end of all we know. A new beginning. Fine. I'm the living one. Do as I say and shut up. Of course. Of course. He composes himself. Forgive my excitement, exalted one. We have waited for you a long time. Let's keep this between us. Of course, but you must listen to me. We were warned by the High Priest to expect your arrival. And he told us to scorn you as an imposter. For some reason, he refuses to believe.
I can understand his position. This whole thing is a bit odd.
There are times when all of us find it difficult to follow the path chosen for us. In the end, does it really matter if you are or weren't? You seem intent on discovering what's happened, and already your Aronox have crossed. If you thwart his plan, you'll have played the role of the living one. Is there any difference in the end?
I suppose not. I just wish people would stop trying to kill me.
I'm not worried. We've come this far. Regardless of what you think, I feel that the fate has chosen a worthy champion. Now, how may I be of service?
Yes. What can I expect from the bitches around here?
You should be very careful.
I have something important to tell you, Alexander.
What? What did you find?
I also found this.
It seems we, the Panari, have an important responsibility. Many of your trouble, living one, were born because we allowed ourselves to be deceived for so many years. That will be no longer. And it seems my family has deceived and dishonored. I think I know of whom I must speak about this.
You hand him the Sword of Manox.
Alexander is stunned, unbelieving. I never hoped to see this. It was lost so many years ago. It will be put to good use, I can assure you.
I'm sure. Goodbye and good luck.
He takes your hand in both of his. Thank you, living one. Your help here has been invaluable. I wish you luck on your quest and in the conflict to come.
Yeah. I'm going my fucking hand.
Hadrian looks up with the haunted eyes.
Hadrian, I found the whole truth. Nothing but the truth, so help me God.
What? Anger flares in the eyes of Hadrian. The man truly was a saint and a warrior, and it seems that we Panari have been neglecting our true duties. That will no longer be the case. He puts a hand to your shoulder.
Somehow, because you're 9 feet taller.
Thank you, my friend. You've done this church and the world a great service.
Glad to be of service, Hadrian.
As a token of my appreciation, feel free to take any of the objects in the display cases. I can't tell you what they'd be good for, but they're all yours. The cases will be open now.
Thank you very much.
Would you do me the favor? Speak with Alexander of these things, if you've already done so. I'm an old man and tired. There's little I can do right this wrong. But Alexander is the strongest of us all, and will know what to do. I envy not the man who Alexander finds responsible.
I'll do that, Hadrian.
The glass key needed for the Iron Clan quest. The Eye of Krakatoa. A And the Finger of Manox, plus critical hit percentage, plus 20. Poison resistance, plus 1 weapon, plus 2 melee. Well, seeing that I really don't have a necklace, even though I'm already resistant. It gives plus 1 willpower too, which is cool. Wearing the Finger of Manox. Hey, plus hit to critical percentage, I'll take it. You can give it to Sog Meat Run, he could probably benefit from it more. This is a low level piece of shit! Let's work on that Iron Clan quest. Let me go into that, you little shit knocker. I'm better off taking a boat back to Turan, it seems. Another fate point. Me wanna go Thanatos! Thanatos, you're not finding me fool enough to take you to that destination around here. Try Blackboot. That place is full of desperate assholes. Me go on boat, me pay. Let's go on to Rant on the way. We finish the Iron Clan quest here. We'll pretty much be on our last leg of our journey here. We're traveling to the town of Mages, and after that, it's pretty much time to wrap it up. We head into the void for the in-game shizmizzle. But before that, we of course have to complete the Ancient Gods quest. We need to get Lugalicious. What the fuck? Alright, time to figure out how the fuck to get there. Aha! Over here on the left side, I might have a marker up here. Shit looks legit to me. Ancient iron device. This is where you're going to need to use your glass key. Boom shakalaka!
Will you take me to Iron Clan Town? will you take me to Ironclan Town?
Alright, this is the true home of the Ironclan. For the dwarves, if you have long hair or... Magnus. If you have long hair Magnus with you, they will have a discussion here and you can earn an extra fate point. Whoa! So the mechanical bastards. Time to switch to the almighty Arcane Axe. Fuck him up, dog. Stone, which we can return now. Might as well, right? As you can see, we're still gaining experience. For those that haven't heard, I've added the level cap mod, which allows me to go to level 127, I believe. Not that I'll be anywhere close to that. No thanks. I'm going to pretty much beeline toward the end of the game at this point. We've pretty much hit most of the extra quests that Luglug would really be able to do. We've done actually a lot more because of intelligence potions and the plus one ring of intelligence. You can see throughout this let's play that a character with less than 5 intelligence is severely limited. You pretty much can only go from beginning to end. Side quests are few and far between. I wanted to definitely use the ring here at the end though, because I wanted both the let's plays to kind of not miss out on the main storyline. So that's why I used it in the Panari Temple to talk with everyone to kind of keep the full story in bloom. And I can be the first to say that we got plenty of dum-dum talk throughout this venture. Luglug find his way. Maybe. I found Ironclan here to destroy it, dog! You have, my god! I never dreamed I meant It will reel the stone. It's beautiful.
He is silent for a long time, turning the stone over in his hands.
And what of the Iron Clan? What did you see? It's more than I ever hoped or dreamed. It seems that truly were advanced far beyond what anyone could have known.
I look so forward to visiting the caverns of the Iron Clan and learning of the way.
Thank you, my friend. You've no idea the gift you bestowed on us all. Bye-bye. But what gift did you bestow upon me, Luglug asked. Nothing much, it looks like. But quest is finished. Nevertheless, Luglug is content.
Alright, so now it's all about sailing to the island of Thanatos. Now, there's a boat in Blackroot that you can buy for 50,000 gold to get there. Or if you have really good gambling skill, you can also gamble your way there. I, however, am going to be seeking to talk to Stringy Pete.
Who's Stringy Pete, you might ask? Oh, well, he's probably the most difficult fight in the entire game. If you decide to fight him, you can also not fight him.
Alright, before we get too ahead of ourselves, I'm going to beeline down. Whoa. Don't go to Ashbury yet. Just head down that way. Looking for another one of their altars here.
I don't like you. I kill you.
And there's Vuridin. This is the Greater God Temple of the First Circle.
Yes, what do you want?
Hi, I'm not too smart, to you?
I'm Edwin Wallace, a priest of the Harkonnen Order here in Vuridin. How might I help you?
I ask you questions. What is this temple?
This temple here is the ancient one, my friend. It is used for the god Halison. You see, long ago there were many gods, and each god represented a particular virtue. A man chose his gods carefully. Religion was a very serious thing. All of the gods were created by the All-Father, who ruled over them and saw that none were more important or more powerful than the others. The balance between gods was well maintained, and no one religion was more powerful than the other.
What happened?
I suppose it's just the way of things to change. The Panari religion came around speaking of Dazzledine and his wisdom. Their religion was much easier than the more forgiving. The old gods are not the way. And though their voices is faint, you can still hear them, and they still hear those who call them. We of the Halcyon Order still worship the god Halcyon.
I might ask you questions about religion.
Of course. What can I tell you about beliefs?
Can I make offering to your god?
I'm sorry, but no one has made a true offering to Halcyon in almost 200 years.
Why?
Well, 2 centuries ago, there was an evil pirate named Stringy Pete. He was a piece of dog shit and an absolute devil. There isn't an act of malice, debauchery, or irreverence that he didn't commit while he still sailed the seas of Arcanum. And then one day, he dropped anchor just west of here and found our small village. He and his men destroyed everything in town, pillaging what they wanted and burning the rest. When they found the temple, well, let's just say that the old pirate did things to our altar that need never be spoke of again. There hasn't been an offering made on the altar since.
Why you not get new altar?
It's not quite that easy. You see, there are rules to pertaining to making of altars.
What rules?
Well, the important thing is that stones come from the ancient dwarven quarry of Torin. That way there is dangerous, and this quarry itself is overrun with monsters of all manner.
Maybe I could go.
Perhaps you might be able to do so. The stone you will need to retrieve will be a large and heavy. Unless you are very strong, I recommend you try and find Murgo. He's a half-ogre who works around here, and he might be able to help you.
Where Torin Quarry?
The Torin Quarry is west of here, near the base of Stonewall Mountains. He points to a place on your map. You should be able to find a suitable stone lying around. We are poor folk here. I can't offer you anything but our thanks.
Okay, I do it.
Thank you so much for your help. Make sure to find Murdo if you'd like his help. I wish you luck, and may the blessing of Halcyon be with you.
Fuck! Hi, Murgo. I Lug Lug.
Hey, you dumb like me. I like you, Lug Lug.
I like you, Murgo. I ask you questions.
Sure, Murgo like to talk.
What you do her, Murgo?
I help priestesses. If they need Murgo do something, then I do it. Like lift heavy things and break things and stuff. And they give me food and nice bed. Nice priestesses.
Okay. Wallow say you might help me.
If Mr. Wallow say okay, then maybe I help you. What you need help with?
I need you to help me carry something.
Okay.
So come with me.
Okay, I help you, but we need there right away. I have to come back here and help priestesses again.
Okay, we leave for a quarry right away.
Wow, a triple ogre entourage. You definitely don't want to fuck with this shit, folks. No siree. We're talking triple quarry entourage. It's bangerific. Now, where the fuck is Torrance Quarry? There it is. Alright, so they're gonna make us go up here to Torrance. And then boom shakalaki over to Torin Quarry. Fantastico, let's head over there. I'm excited. Are you excited? You guys watching, you're excited? Alright, good deal. I fucking love you guys.
Where are all the monsters at, Lug Lug?
We probably scare them away. You are traveling with the Demon Lord Lug Lug, after all.
Alright, all kinds of monkeys to fucking kill.
See how I shrug off damage?
That's cool, Lug Lug. Let me try to hit one.
Oh, well, my little dog can do more damage than you, you puss.
You a good fighter, Lug Lug.
No shit, Sherlock! I Lug Lug. I come from the dark sands of Arthas.
Where's Arthas?
That faraway planet. Don't get killed. I don't want to explain to your master why I bring you back dead. This rock be. Hello. Dog, why are you so slow? You're the only one not carrying shit.
Looks like you already picked up the stone. Oh, Murgo. You're fucking efficient. I'd like that in a half ogre.
Let's go, Murgo!
Okay.
Zug Zug. No, it's Lug Lug, dummy. You played too much Warcraft when you were little. I will kill you. How many of you are there? God damn! So tired of picking gold off your dead corpse. Luglug about to hit level 5-1. You can really be Demon Lord. You like football player. You run around all my party. Pretty funny to watch. I got Alterstone. Whoa!